Gosh, I look so pale. This is what New York does to you. And all the Korean skincare product.
This is what LA does to you. Damage. Hey there, fellow beauty finders. It's Mathias for Makeup. And today I'm sitting down in my Monday Makeup Chat studio with my good friend, fellow makeup artist, Nick Lujan. Yay, Nick's back.
I'm so happy. I'm excited to be here. I had so much fun last time.
Thank you. If you hadn't seen any of those videos that we've already done from last year, please check down below in the description section because we did a whole series. And today and coming up this year, we're going to be doing a whole new series together because Nick, you are officially my favorite guest star ever.
Oh my gosh. I'm so honored. Thank you so much. Cheers to that.
So in part one of this multi-part series here on my Monday Makeup Chat with my special guest, Nick, we're going to be talking about his tips and techniques for perfecting your skin without wearing a mask. You know, one of the things that I wanted him to help show you all is what he likes to use for kind of like perfecting the skin without, you know, literally like pumping out five things of foundation and smearing it all over the face. I know so many social media stars and kids are doing it these days. And I know I have a lot of fans on my YouTube channel who are, you know, mature women. And they don't want to wear a mask of makeup. So what are your thoughts on the kind of that whole idea or that process?
There's totally a place and time for every style of makeup. You should have a wardrobe. You should always have full coverage and a light coverage based on what your needs are. So that being said, I think it's nice to kind of lighten it up, lighten up the coverage, especially as we age. Like, we want to look like we painted the garage door solid with foundation and primer and then rebuilt the whole entire house. Like, you can use what you have. Use your natural beauty and just kind of pinpoint where you want your coverage with the right product. You have to have a good product for that.
Exactly. Okay, so you talked about everyone needing to have a wardrobe, like different looks, you know, sometimes light, sometimes heavy, sometimes medium. How do you help a woman decide whether or not she's going to buy a full coverage foundation or a tinted moisturizer or a pan stick, you know, formula or stick foundation?
Sure. I think the first thing you want to do is, what is the makeup you're trying to achieve? What's the look you're going for? What's the story you want to tell? Sometimes you want a little extra coverage because maybe you're going out to an event, it's a little bit darker lighting, maybe you want to look smoother. So there's so many different ways to achieve that, but I think full coverage from a stick foundation, something really lightweight, something silicone based, that's easy to blend and stretch with small particles. If it's like really thick and dry and it drags across your face, that's not the right stick foundation.
No, right?
You want something more emollient, right?
Right.
And that's what I would consider to be like leggings. So think about your wardrobe. You have leggings in your wardrobe. When do you want to cover those legs up and cover everything and hide everything and pull it up a little bit tighter with leggings? Full coverage. Sometimes you want a medium coverage. So maybe you're just having like a bad skin day, a little minor breakout. You want to put on something that's going to cover a little bit more, but not as heavy as like a cream or a full coverage foundation. Mm-hmm. Think of that as your dance tights. They still do the coverage where you need them. They give you a little more shape, but you can still see through them a little bit. So that would be like a liquid foundation, something that's medium coverage that you can build up to full coverage in certain areas where you need it.
Maybe with like a concealer as an addition.
Now we're going to talk about the sheer coverage, which I would consider pantyhose. Think about what pantyhose do for your legs. They smooth and even out things. They hide a little bit of texture or discoloration.
But you can still see the hair through them.
You can still see through them. You can still see a few veins or a little bruise, but you know, it's really light coverage is just like really same thing like pantyhose. It just kind of smooths and evens out the canvas, but you still look like you. You don't look like you're wearing a ton of makeup. And I think that's where I'm the most comfortable these days. I think it's nice to have that wardrobe option.
And that would be, just to clarify, that would be like the BB creams, the CC creams, the tinted moisturizers, generally
speaking. Yeah, anything that says like for face and body is typically a really sheer application for a product. So along with your different coverages in your wardrobe of makeup, you should also have different colors in your wardrobe of makeup. Mm. Especially if you're going to go with a fuller coverage, you might need multiple colors of foundation. So the easiest is the most sheer coverage. Your pantyhose, because it's really sheer, you don't lose a lot of dimension. But think about how you build coverage. Then you go into your dance tights and you don't really necessarily see that you have color from blood under your skin anymore.
Right.
And then when you go full coverage, if you don't contour and highlight, you're gonna look like a thumb, like you're just gonna look flat.
So exactly.
It's nice to have different color foundations around so that you can highlight and contour in a natural way.
That is so interesting because I think a lot of girls and women and more mature ladies are watching a lot of these YouTubers and Instagram personalities, you know, paint their face like he said, like the garage door, all one color, full coverage, completely erasing any pigment in their skin. But when they're only using one color, what happens? You lose all dimension in your face because it's completely blasting out anything that's naturally happening from lights and shadows and blood, like you said. So if you're going to do a full coverage, you really need to highlight, contour, or have two different colors of foundation. And that is so, so, so important. What are your thoughts down below? Do you actually understand that concept? Do you understand what we're trying to help you kind of see for the first time by watching me here on Find the Beauty? So I want Nick to show you exactly what he likes to do for a light medium coverage for somebody who doesn't want to wear a mask of makeup, somebody who just wants to perfect their imperfections in a really sophisticated way. So we're going to do that demo now. Okay, so I'm really excited to see your concealing techniques because you talked about them last year. So, okay, so what are some things we need to know about concealing? Because I need a lot of it.
Great. I'm gonna talk to you about a few different products and textures that we can utilize to really help with like smoothing out texture as well as hiding redness and maybe a little discoloration and maybe help stimulate the circulation around the eye area, because that's the number one reason for dark circles. You know that. Everyone says it's because we stayed out late and partied all night long, but a lot of times it's hereditary and it's the blood flow is just kind of slow in that area. Mm-hmm. So we gotta get that blood moving. So you wanna get a concealer that's gonna do that for you. So I have a couple options and things to share with you. But yeah, you should always scrape out product, and it's okay if you see your artist not doing that, like to say, hey, do you mind just scraping it out? Or would rather be sanitary. But if you know that they've already been doing it a lot, you might think about using that artist again or finding a new one.
Mm-hmm. All right, so what are these?
These are Ultra HD underpainting palettes. Ooh. I just bought them all and took them all out and stuck them in one palette together. So for me, traveling with my makeup, this helps me to condense my kit. This is my concealer, my highlight, my corrector, and my contour, like everything in one. So it makes life so much easier. Yeah. I want to test a few colors first, and then we'll decide what we want to do. Excuse me, it's best when you're testing a concealer to really test it on the area you're going to be using it. And then if you're lucky enough to have a camera and a setup like us, I'm going to peek over at the monitor for 2 seconds. I can look over to see how it's reading on camera. So like, take a picture of your makeup halfway through your makeup or when you're testing the product so that you can see that it looks good on you with flash, without flash, in daylight or regular light.
That's a really interesting topic I would love to cover with you on Monday Makeup Chat, maybe talking about doing makeup for camera as opposed to doing makeup for somebody who's not going to be photographed. And are there specific like things that you think about or do you ask? Like, does it change your makeup? Maybe we'll talk about that.
Oh, that'd be awesome. That's going to be a topic for next time, right?
Yeah.
Sorry, I'm getting off topic. So I'm just going to place my concealer. I think that's a good color. I'm looking in the monitor. It's not reading too yellow or too red. And it's not heavy, heavy coverage. It's really natural.
Now, when you're choosing a color and you're putting it like right here in the T-zone, like the middle of the face, for people at home who maybe don't understand what a T-zone is, the middle of the face, are you also going to kind of use that same color throughout the face? Or do you find that you use a darker color on the perimeters or lighter colors in the center? Like, what's your way of doing
it? There's a couple different ways of doing it. Some people will block out the whole face with one color and then add color on top of it using like a bronzer or a highlighter, that kind of stuff. But for male grooming for television or red carpet, I want to keep it a little bit lighter. I don't want them to look like they're wearing a lot of makeup. So I'll use multiple colors of concealer, place them where I need them. So no one is really one color. Not one person on this planet is really one color. There should be multiple colors of foundations and concealers. So where on Mathias, I'm using a lighter shade through the center here because that matches his natural highlights that I'm seeing under his brow bone and where the light hits his nose and on his forehead. I'm picking a color that kind of blends into that. So choosing your color to blend into the way your skin is reading on camera can be really helpful. I don't want it to look heavy and I don't want it to look overdone. I still want it to look glamorous, just not overdone. I'm gonna choose maybe something a little bit darker, or I might mix a couple colors together in the areas that I want to push back or sculpt a little bit. So
you have such a light touch.
Thank you. I'm not trying to beat the mug.
Yet.
Honey, we spent a lot of money to look this fresh. I don't want to damage the goods. Yeah, so really light touch. I'm using a really soft, fluffy brush instead of a hard brush or a beauty blender. I find that those either put too much product on or too little product. So I like a brush like this is a 144 brush, tapered on all sides so I can get into like every little nook and cranny. I can be very detailed as an artist. And it's big enough to where I can cover larger areas if I need to. So as you noticed, I put concealer like a little bit everywhere, but there's certain areas where I've concentrated a little bit more coverage. The cool thing about a product like this is the underpainting palette, is you can build coverage, you can layer it up. So maybe here he needs a little extra coverage, I can put another layer right in there. And it's pretty stable. It's silicone based, so it's not going to be absorbed into your skin, but it's going to look just like skin. So it's kind of magical.
Now, what's the difference between this under, what do you call it, the undercover base?
Underpainting palette.
Underpainting palette. Is this the same formula as in the Makeup Forever Pan Stick?
It's the same formula as in the Ultra HD Stick.
Got it.
Yes. Okay.
So why did they call it just the HD Stick Pans or something? Like, why does it have a fun name?
It's got a fun name because when you purchase it, you get 4 different shades in your palette. So you get a few different things for underpainting. So that's really color correcting. It's kind of what they're getting at. It's underpainting underneath your foundation. Okay. So you've got 2 colors of foundation, one light one and one dark one. Remember, no one is really one color. So you have to have one that's lighter and one that's a little bit darker. And then you have your underpainting palettes too for correction.
Oh.
And it's built out by skin tone. It's pretty accurate too. I was actually lucky enough to be in Paris and help develop this particular product when we were choosing colors.
Wow.
Yeah. So it's nice to have a little bit of everything in your kit. And then I can adopt from the different palettes for the different contours and highlights and things like that if I'm going to do something a little higher scale in contrast, like drag makeup. So I might take a little bit of a darker shade now just to kind of like touch a few other areas. And I'm going to put it next to the lighter shade that I have on my hand. So I can kind of control the volume of dark that I'm putting in the product. So I can turn it up or I can turn it down.
You're custom blending it on your hand.
Custom blending. And as a pro, when you custom blend, it means money in your pocket. Because if somebody loves what you do, where else can they get that? It's custom blended for you. So you have to call me, Mathias, when you want me to do your male grooming again.
Yes.
So I'm just putting a little bit of this darker color right through here. not to say anything, but...
No, believe me, it's sun damage from laying in the sun way too many years.
Taking in that sun has caused an effect later on in life, and I'm sure I'm going to see it too, because I'm from the desert, so... But if you go with a little bit of a darker, like a brown shade here in this area, it helps to kind of cover and conceal and blend that in. It kind of fades it into the rest of the skin tone. And then later on, we'll add a little bit of bronzer to also help marry the two together, the highlight and the contour that we're doing. Notice for highlighting contour and male grooming, I'm not going extreme contrast. He's not going to be on stage in a theater somewhere where he's viewed from far away. So I'm keeping it low contrast. Let's say I was doing this for stage, I might use this as his highlight shade and go even a little bit darker for sculpting. That'll ensure that that makeup is seen from the back of the audience. It's an interesting thing to be a makeup artist that works both stage and photo shoots and all of those things. You have to be able to pull from all of that in order to create a look that's going to be well received by the cameras or by the audience. So just know who your audience is. It really helps you determine your colors and how deep you should go with your sculpting and how light you should go with your contours. I like to do really thin layers when I'm working like this, because at some point it's going to be enough and I can stop. If I go in really heavy handed, it's going to be hard to pull back later on. It's harder to remove than it is to build up when you're working with makeup. And that's true of any style of makeup. Better to kind of start out a little bit lighter. And once I get to know somebody, a client, like I'll just automatically know what to do. I can just go straight into it. Okay.
Here we are though.
So we've got our highlighter color through the center and it's really close to his skin tone. Then I went a little bit darker just in the areas where I'm transitioning from his natural contours into his natural light. I'm not changing the bone structure, keeping it simple.
So I hope you enjoyed this week's episode of this series that I'm doing with Nick Lujan. I want to hear your comments and thoughts down below. Please do follow us both on all of our social media. Nick is an incredible makeup artist and he's got some beautiful work on his Instagram. And I would love for you to please make sure that you subscribe to my channel because Nick is coming back. We have many more videos to showcase for you here on my YouTube channel in 2019. Thank you so much.
Thank you. I always enjoy coming here. I can't wait for what's next.
Oh, should we tell them maybe what's coming up in a few months?
Ooh, yeah.
Nick is going to be painting my face for a Halloween extravaganza video, you guys. He's going to be painting me up as my alter ego, Miss Lady Reveille. So stay tuned, make sure you're subscribed, and we will see you next time. Bye for now.